चंद्रकांत है अभी हमारे सर्विस में था और ही इज नाउ मूविंग टू मोस्ट लाइकली IRS
गोइंग बाय लास्ट ईयर ट्रेंड
IRS मिलने वाला है. रिक्वेस्टेड हिम एंड ही आल्सो एग्रीड ऑन वेरी शॉर्ट नोटिस. ठीक है, तो ताकि हम लोग बात कर सके, हम लोग समझ सकें कि मतलब कैसे तैयारी किया, कैसे क्या किया, बिकॉज ही हैव बीन वर्किंग. मैंने तो तुम्हें छुट्टी लेते हुए नहीं देखा. ठीक है ठीक है, तो ही हैव बीन वर्किंग और साथ में तैयारी किया है. ठीक है, तो अपने आप में एक बहुत इंपॉर्टेंस रहता है कि वर्किंग के साथ में भी तैयारी कर पाना पॉसिबल है. तो सारी बातें हम थोड़ा सा पूछेंगे, तुम लोग को भी जो बीच बीच में डाउट आते रहेगा वो पूछते रहना. अच्छा सर, मैं सबसे पहले ये बताओ कि अभी जो प्रीलिम्स है इनका एक डेढ़ महीने बचा है, तो तुम्हारे हिसाब से खास करके जो लोग पहली बार दे रहे हैं, जिनके लिए ये पहला सीरियस अटेम्प्ट है, तो तुम्हें क्या लगता है मतलब कितना टाइम एटलीस्ट इनको अभी मेंस भूल के टोटली प्रीलिम्स पे फोकस करना चाहिए सब कुछ?
सर जो फर्स्ट टाइम अटेम्प्ट दे रहे हैं उनको तो 50 डेज तो मिनिमम देना
चाहिए.
50 डेज मतलब फॉर प्रीलिम्स. So I think we only have 50 more days.
सही टाइम तो हाँ राइट, मतलब 50 दिन तो देना बनता
है. मिनिमम
ठीक है, अनसर्टेनिटी की वजह से है या क्या मतलब?
हाँ अनसर्टेनिटी सर, स्पेशली इन प्रीलिम्स इट्स द मार्किंग इज ओनली फॉर 200 मार्क्स.
ओके,
एंड लास्ट दिस ईयर कट ऑफ इज अराउंड 98. I am sure there will be between 98 and 100, there will be 2000 people, and between 98 and 96 there will be another 3000 people. So the level of competition is such that even one mark can, you know, waste your 1 year of investment in a way. Because if you miss the prelims, then you have to wait for one more year. And what I have seen is like especially if you lose, if you do not clear prelims or any stage, then you will lose the momentum in this exam. So that way I think it's very important first you clear prelims, and that is one thing. And second thing is if you clear the prelims with some margin and you are certain after your prelims day you are certain that you are clearing prelims, then the way you utilize the next 1 month before the actual prelims results are out is very different from otherwise. How would you use if you are in border case? If you are in border case, you don't feel like 100% giving your energy. When the results are out, even if you clear, then you feel like you can't have already wasted 1 month. So I do not want, it is not, it's very few people who can, irrespective of being there in border, they can give their 100%. But let's not be in that situation in first. Why cannot we clear prelims with a margin and then be confident about our main preparation? And 50 days is bare minimum.
Bare minimum,
given the competition, number of seats, and given the nature of exam. So 50 days is basic minimum. And even if you, and the amount of time between prelims and mains is sufficient enough for mains. So there is nothing that you have to read right now. So I would suggest to go for prelims and prelims exclusively prelims from today, and then we can see how we have to strategize after prelims.
अच्छा, इसी से एक रिलेटेड नेक्स्ट सवाल है कि इतना अनसर्टेन हो गया, प्रीलिम्स को सब बोल रहे हैं अनसर्टेन है, तो इसको अनसर्टेनिटी को कैसे सर्टेनिटी में बदलते हो? हाउ यू कन्वर्ट?
हां सर, नाउ आई आंसर दिस नॉट फ्रॉम ए पर्सपेक्टिव दैट आई एम वेरी एक्सपर्ट इन दिस, बट आई जस्ट वांट टू मेक इट वेरी क्लियर दैट आई हैव नॉट क्लियर लास्ट टू प्रीलिम्स.
ओके,
बिकॉज ऑफ विच आई हैड टू वेट फॉर ऑलमोस्ट 2-3 years टू गिव माई नेक्स्ट फुल प्लेस्ड अटेम्प्ट. So in that sense, prelims is very, very, very important, number one, because if you don't clear that, you will not get the experience of mains. In my case, since I'm already in service, so I already had experience of mains and interview. So I knew that if I clear prelims, then I'll be able to, handle the mains and interview confidently. But especially for those who haven't given mains even once, it is very, very important that you clear prelims. And to address the uncertainty, one thing is there is no specific pattern in the prelims, number one. Sometimes it is current affairs dominated, sometimes it is static dominated. Few years if you see it is culture dominated, few years environment dominated. So given this level of competition, you cannot take any risk. You have to do well in all the subjects. Like you cannot leave any subject altogether and assume that questions will not come from there. So I would suggest to do basic minimum from the all the subjects rather than leaving any particular subject. Definitely you have to do how, I mean, the ratio of how much time you are investing and what could be possible returns. That is there because, for example, something like quality is very rewarding. But culture may not be as rewarding. But you can, you have to do basic minimum of culture so that at least the average questions and simple questions of culture, you have to do it 100% correctly. Otherwise, the strategy is like you have to do easy questions and average questions of all the subjects correctly. And there will be few questions which you will have expertise in one or two subjects and you will get those 10 more marks so that you will be comfortable.
Well.
And the best way to prepare for the prelims is write as many as practice tests.
Practice
tests. So the one way of addressing uncertainty is at the end of the day we are making intelligent guesses. And it is not also like very random. There is a pattern to it. That is something which you develop when you are practicing question papers. So if you say if you do 50 prelims question papers of different nature, then that itself has already thrown you so many surprises. In the exam, you will not feel, you know, any new question as a very surprise.
What particular test series you will attend?
I do not have any particular test series. In the market, whatever is available, you can just pick 5 test papers of each. Like, choose 5 test series and do 10 papers from each. So that way you have covered various ways of asking questions.
Sure.
It might happen that one test series, in particular one test series questions might have been more. So you just do 5 different test papers and do 10 each test paper. So that way you can cover 50 tests. We have one test a day from now onwards. And sufficiently it will cover all current affairs, static portion and of all the subjects.
So prelims ke liye to I think we have done enough questions. Next question I wanted to know कि mains के अगर part पे हैं तो GS मतलब ऐसे लोग देखते हैं GS और फिर देखते हैं optional separate they look at separately और I think preparation strategy writing strategy भी थोड़ा सा differ करता है it does differ तो उसमें कैसे balance करना है कि GS कितना पढ़ें optional कितना पढ़ें because sometimes people focus क्योंकि marks ज़्यादा है तो कभी कभी लोग जीएस पे ज्यादा पढ़ते हैं न्यूज़पेपर से रिलेटेड है तो दे गेट इनटू जीएस और फिर कभी कभी ऑप्शनल साइड में हो जाता है बट अगेन द वेरिएशन मेरे हिसाब से बहुत ज्यादा कई बार ऑप्शनल में आता है तो हाउ टू हैंडल ऑल दोस काइंड ऑफ मतलब हाउ टू हैंडल दिस बैलेंस
अगेन एज आई सेड वी आर नॉट वेरी श्योर विच ईयर विच पेपर वुड परफॉर्म बेटर एंड विच पेपर वुड परफॉर्म समटाइम्स एसे स्कोरिंग इज सो आई मीन सो हाई दैट इफ यू Even if you perform average, then there will be 30 marks difference between the good scorers. So you cannot assume anything that this year I do optional specific, let's say something like this, or I do GS and I'll give less time to optional. You have to give basic minimum time to all the subjects. That is very, very important, number one. And number two, handling GS and optional together differs for different people. For example, somebody with mathematics or engineering background, the way he will see the GS is different because there is no overlap. But somebody with PAPAD, political science, sociology, so these history, these people, the way they do GS is different because you have an overlap. But at the same time, having overlap is advantage. At the same time, you have to be very careful in the sense the way you write the quality answer in general studies is different from how you write in public administration and political science. So that is very, you have to be very clear and you have to, especially the people with humanities options should try to be not theoretical in their general studies answers and write general studies like general studies. And in fact, in general studies, there is no differentiation between for our sake, we say paper one is history, geography and sociology, but in general studies for all practical purposes, there is no great difference between each paper. All the papers you have to write a general studies answer.
खास करके general studies में current affairs का weightage और जो भी news में है ज़्यादा वो ज़्यादा पूछा जाता है. That's what I have seen. News तो इतना सारा आता है, right? There is so much news. How do you identify the topics?
So one mistake probably I have done in my previous attempts or one learning I would say is we give disproportionate time to paper 2 and paper 3 current affairs. But if you see the last year paper 2 general studies, if you see there are 5 questions from, say, basic quality Lakshmikant. Okay. So,
static questions.
Static questions.
Okay.
And we give, probably many of us give disproportionately more time to internet and relations. But if you see, there will be 2-3 most important topics they are asking questions, and they are not getting into historical part of relations, bilateral relations, these days. So, if you see that way, we have to like strategize, like you have to see where the marks are coming from. We should not be passionate about anything, whether it is newspaper reading or whether it is current affairs or static. You have to give equal weightage. Equal, when I say equal weightage, in proportion to how much marks you can get and how many questions are being asked from that particular section, and prepare accordingly. And when it comes to preparing, especially current affairs of paper 2 and paper 3, general studies, I would suggest you to keep it for the last 1 month or last 45 days.
Okay.
Because there will be lots of happenings which will be happening on day-to-day basis. Instead of you studying that particular topic, what is happening on day-to-day basis, you wait and you let give some time. And after, say, 2 months into your main preparation, starting from prelims, then you can do this exercise of identifying the topics and preparing some summary of 1 or 2 pages of that sort, and then do it. That is more time-efficient way of handling current affairs. And by the time, initial phase, I would suggest to invest before prelims, immediately after prelims, before the prelims results are out, I would suggest everybody to finish their option.
Okay. Matlab wo jo uncertainty ka period.
Uncertainty ka period.
You just use that for optional.
Finish the optional.
अच्छा नोट्स खुद बनाए थे या जैसे सेल्फ प्रिपेयर्ड होता है 365
माय ऑप्शंस फॉर माय ऑप्शन आई हैव हैंड रिटन नोट्स क्लासरूम नोट्स एंड फ्रॉम दैट आई हैव मेड इट वाज जस्ट 3 नोटबुक्स एंड फ्रॉम दैट आई हैव मेड 1 नोटबुक आउट ऑफ 1 नोटबुक
ऑफ कॉन्सेप्ट्स
एंड दैट इज व्हाट आई हैव डन फॉर माय ऑप्शनल एंड दैट इज व्हाट आई यूज्ड टू रिक्वेस्ट इवन इफ देयर इज एनी करंट डेवलपमेंट्स और न्यू writer, thinker's name which I have to mention, or new books which I have to quote, I would add to my notes. But at the end of the day, it is one small notebook
which I will revise
again and again. For the optional. For general studies, I do not have any notes sort of a thing. What I have is, I did current affairs from mains 365.
Mm-hmm.
Now there is Vision Insights, so various study groups are releasing. So I used to do notes out of them only. So I do not have any specific notes. But for paper 2, paper 3 general studies, current affairs, topic wise notes I have.
Okay.
That is also very concise.
But that is for static part?
No, current affairs part.
Oh, current affairs part. One page, two page. Okay. But newspaper padhna jaruri hai, right? You can skip that part.
It is also again different for different people. For example, someone like me, I am not giving that up for the first time. But when I was giving my first attempt, I have for the first 2 years continuously every day I have read newspaper. So once you do that for, let's say, 1 year or minimum of 2 years or even 1 year, you can understand what is important, what is not important. You can do newspaper in half an hour, 40 minutes, just to be in touch with what is happening. I would tell you to read newspaper to stay in touch with to keep the current affairs. As you have earlier asked, what are the topics which are there in news? Wo jaane ke liye newspaper padhna zaruri hai, taki you will get a sense of importance ki bahut sare par kaun se articles aa rahe, what are the current happenings. But lekin notes banane ke liye main newspaper suggest nahi karunga. I would suggest some monthly compilation or main 365 compilation.
Because it helps. Concise way, they give you the history, give you the relevant facts.
Basically, what you have to do, somebody else is doing it for you. So why
should do it? Okay. That's.
But now to stay in touch with current affairs, to understand what is important, what is not important, guess which question will come in the exam, it is important to know what is happening in the current affairs. For that, newspaper is one option. Watching Rajya Sabha Big Picture is another option. Air India Snippets is another option.
Mm-hmm.
And reading PIB News is one option. So there are various options. Whichever is suitable to you, you can do it.
Not all of them. It's both general sir question. I have just written at the top. what qualities मतलब preparation के phase में क्या करना चाहिए ही क्या नहीं करना चाहिए that kind of things.
क्या नहीं करना चाहिए taking too many breaks, too longer breaks. So because to build a momentum, if you study 10 for 10 days, the amount, the frequency at which you will be grasping is altogether different than you are reading it day one. But if you take a break of 5 days, to come to that point itself, you have to invest 5 days. So don't take a longer break. Okay. Take, let's say you can take, you study for 6 days, you take half a day break for on a Sunday or Saturday, whatever suits you. But not longer breaks and not too many breaks.
Navratri nahi manana. Next sir, मतलब तुमसे पूछ के तो खैर फिर भी can working people do मतलब qualify कर सकते हैं can working
people definitely do? Working people can qualify this exam because I am in Indian Trade Service, which sir is my senior in that service, and it's not like very leisurely job or anything of that sort. When we are in office, we were completely occupied, and in fact, when I was in office, I am in office. When I am at home preparing, I am preparing. But I never try to mix both of them. That is number one. And number two, it is a different strategy for people who have not even given one attempt exclusively. For example, this is my understanding. For an average student, it is important that he spends exclusively 1 year preparing for this exam. Once he has done that, then I would suggest he should join some job. After that, it is 1 month before prelims and 2 months before mains is what matters. This after you have spending one long year in that cycle. But if you are studying for the very first time along with the job, then definitely it is very challenging.
Very challenging.
It requires a dedication of different level altogether. But even then, there are people who have done that. But in my opinion, I would say if there is a choice, prepare for 1 year exclusively for this exam. After your first mains, then you can join some job and parallelly you can interview you can manage along with the job very easily. And the prelims you need 20 days halt, 3 weeks before prelims. If you can get the leaves from the office, then you can manage. But for mains, you need at least 45 days break. 45 days break before the mains would do. But of course, this is for people
who are very dedicated.
You are dedicated who have spent one cycle.
One cycle at least. Dedicated portion, jab de doge, then with continuing job, you can do it with ease. At least 3-4 ghante bhi daily diya, to bhi ho jayega.
But lekin, matlab, when I say this, it is assumed that aapka pehle cycle mein aapne sort out kar liya ki kaun sa kitab padhna hai, aapne sort out kar liya ki aapka matlab optional ke liye aapka handwritten ya matlab concise material aapke paas hai. So when you are sorted on those fronts, you can do this. But you cannot be figuring out in every new attempt that main is baar kya kitab padunga. So you cannot ask those questions again and again.
Okay. As a self study kitna matter karta hai, bahut log jo coaching bhi join karte hain, theek hai, bahut log coaching nahi bhi join karte hain. तो उसमें क्या क्या लगता है सेल्फ स्टडी से पॉसिबल है क्या चाहिए क्या नहीं चाहिए
सेल्फ स्टडीज आज की डेट में पॉसिबल है बिकॉज देर आर लॉट्स ऑफ ऑनलाइन कंटेंट अवेलेबल इनफैक्ट टुडे द चैलेंज इज वी हैव मोर कंटेंट वी हैव टू कल आउट व्हाट इज यूजफुल एंड व्हाट इज नॉट यूजफुल सो इन दैट सेंस देर इज एनफ कंटेंट ऑन द इंटरनेट एंड इवन द एनफ गाइडेंस इज ऑन देर ऑन इंटरनेट सो सेल्फ स्टडी इज पॉसिबल बट ऑप्शन प्रोबेबली यू वुड नीड सम असिस्टेंस बिकॉज there is a way of writing because optional papers are connected by people who are expert in that optional. So there is a basic standard which is expected. So to that extent, it is better if you have a guide in that subject. But general studies is like general studies. You can do it on your own.
Okay, mera question to exhaust ho gaya. Tum log kuch poochho. Is it possible
एसे के लिए एक्चुअली देयर टू पार्ट्स कंटेंट यू शुड हैव एंड यू शुड ऑर्गेनाइज इट प्रॉपरली एंड यू द लैंग्वेज एंड वेब प्रॉपरली बट देयर आर थ्री पार्ट्स कंटेंट पार्ट बाय द टाइम यू क्लियर योर प्रीलिम्स एंड यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर द मेन यू विल हैव एनफ कंटेंट सो कंटेंट इज नॉट अ प्रॉब्लम फॉर एसे एंड देयर इज एनफ चॉइस फॉर यू हैव टू चूज वन आउट ऑफ फोर So there will be one subject of your interest at least. So content what you are sorted. As you are preparing for mains, content is sorted. Then the organization part is again, it comes with the practice. You may not write full complete essay, but you should know how to organize your essay. That you get only when you think about at least 10-20 essays, even sitting at home.
And you should write also.
You should write also. If you are writing for the first time, you should at least write, say, 10 essays. Mm-hmm. 10 essays you should write. And to start with, I would suggest you read topper's essays which are already there in the net. You pick, say, 20 to 30 topics, what already toppers have written. And you read those 30 essays, then you will develop, one way of writing of your own. Because you will also have some strength which might align with some other topper or it might not align. But if you read 10 to 30 papers of toppers, then you will be able to find out your own strategy. So now then, in the second level, you have, by looking at the topper's essays, you have now know that how to organize your essay. The third is the practice part. That there is no replacement, you have to write 10 essays. Or at least 5. Minimum 5, but I would suggest 10. The last 10 weeks before the exam, last one, at least one a week you can do.
Sir, GS and your paper to start is something in common with the optional level. So GS is the content to look so way for the news paper, books, whatever. So I think kya hota hai ki matlab difference hua hai to master matlab kis tarike se likhna hai.
Presentation mein difference hai. And also, one thing is even after a sufficient amount of practice, to complete GS paper in time, giving decent amount of time to all the questions is a challenge in itself. Many of the times what happens is you have more content and you don't know what to pick and what not to pick. So when it comes to GS, I think the real challenge is not lack of material knowledge, but to have write the appropriate content and give time to all the questions equally. So that is the most important thing, to give equal time to all the questions to complete the paper, number two. And number three, presentation. And the presentation, let me tell you, you have to write 250 words for 20 questions. All this will happen only if you have practiced a sufficient amount of questions before the exam. Basically, there is nothing new which you will think in the exam. Basically, whether you clear the exam or do not clear the exam is decided during your preparation, not in the exam. So, for general studies, it is important that you guess few questions right. It is important that at least out of 20, 10 questions, blindly, in 7 minutes, you address it with decent amount of accuracy. That only happens when you practice sufficient amount of questions before the exam.
Suppose मतलब कोई लड़का मतलब prelims दिया वो boundary course को मतलब confirm नहीं को clear कर पाए दिन तो उस केस में जैसे आप बताए सर कि मतलब option करना चाहिए तो compulsory सर मतलब ये हो सकता
है इट इज जस्ट स्ट्रेटजी आई सजेस्ट करूं बिकॉज़ जनरल स्टडीज में करंट अफेयर्स का कंटेंट ज्यादा है तो इंस्टेड ऑफ डूइंग इट फ्रॉम द डे वन आई थॉट यू शुड डू इट द एंड सो दैट बाय दैट टाइम व्हाट इज इंपॉर्टेंट व्हाट इज नॉट सफिशिएंट मटेरियल विल बी आउट बट देयर इज नो ह्यूज चेंज इन द ऑप्शंस ऑफ So that is why I was suggesting to do it before.
What he is saying is, अगर suppose वो तुम border पढ़ो, तुम्हारी anxiety है, ठीक है? तो मैं तो ये पता है अगले साल भी दे रहे हो. If you are not giving for the next year, तब तो बात अलग है. But if you are sure कि you are appearing for the next year, तो optional तो अगले साल भी तुमको तो use होगा और इस साल भी use होगा, ठीक है? But maybe GS का composition जो है, GS का current affairs का जो सवाल है, that will change next year. तो इसलिए better है कि if you are at the border, तो यू फोकस ऑन द ऑप्शनल क्योंकि तुमको पता है कि अगले साल कुछ नहीं सब अगले साल तो यूज हो ही जाएगा बाकी बचा जो जीएस का पार्ट है वो तुम बाद के टाइम में भी कल आउट कर सकते
हो फ्रॉम दिस ईयर एग्जाम पर्सपेक्टिव इट इज बेटर दैट यू डू द करंट अफेयर्स एट द एंड बाय दैट टाइम आपको यू विल नॉट रिपीट द सेम टॉपिक अगेन एंड अगेन इफ यू डू इन द स्टार्टिंग यू विल अगेन प्रॉब्ली यू नो विच यू विल रिपीट द सेम टॉपिक अगेन Some new development is there in that way. You have to track that also.
Sure.
Instead, you just wait. For example, I'm in India, US-China trade war. On a day-to-day basis, something is happening. Why you put your energy in every on a day-to-day basis? Because there will be one question which will come out of it.
Yes.
So you wait for a couple of months, there will be 10 articles, there will be out of that you make one and you read that.
Ethics के लिए क्या करना चाहिए पेपर टू?
Ethics.
Ethics में इस बार कुछ videos थे topic wise. तो I have prepared, one of my friend has actually prepared notes out of it. And I have used that notes to prepare. So I haven't done directly classes. Okay. Someone else did classes from somewhere and he taught me.
Okay. So
I could only spend hardly say 4 or 5 days on ethics. And that was sufficient. And if you see ethics, at least 40% of paper they are directly asking from the syllabus. So what is there in the syllabus? You should have at least decent answers for those questions. At least those 40% of paper you attend with confidence. Now that is number one. And number two, it is very important to give examples in ethics. And you cannot suddenly think about the examples from your real life in the sitting in an exam. So you should do sufficient amount of brainstorm and even examples, what examples you have to give in which scenario, that also you just write down on a paper. Because over the 3 months you write one or two points. At the end you read all those things will be on top of your mind. Otherwise what happens is in the last few days whatever reading we try to write it there. But if you have a notes of your own, you revise it, then you will be able to presenting the material or the content which you have debated for yourself for over a long duration of time. So that will fetch you more marks. And ethics may, especially if you give personalized examples, it is more appreciated. So then it gives an impression that you have done, you know, at an individual level you have spent some time over thinking over these values which have been expecting from the civil servant.
Okay. इकोनॉमिक सर्वे हो गया इस और मतलब पूरा डायरेक्ट करना बेटर आप रिकमेंड करते हो या कंसाइज जो इसका भी नोट्स आता है
नहीं कंसाइज जो आएगा वही पढ़ लीजिए बिकॉज वी डू नॉट हैव टाइम इनफ टाइम राइट नाउ इफ यू हैव स्टडीड इकोनॉमिक सर्वे व्हेन इट गॉट रिलीज दैट इज द बेस्ट थिंग बट इफ यू हैव नॉट देन गो फॉर द सम बिकॉज If you read economic survey today, it will take 5 days. Probably for entire economy, you have to give 6-7 days. But at least economic survey, just even the summary will give you an idea what are the important topics for the exam. And the content in especially books like economic survey or India yearbook or even NITI 3-year action item. So these contents you can use in all general studies paper, 1, 2, 3. And there is enough content, enough numbers, enough logical arguments. So those you can use 1, 2, 3 at essay even in few options.
Why the questions generally get double income कैसे होगा? These are the questions they have been trying to answer. और यही सारे problems हैं आज के दिन में bureaucracy face भी कर रही है. तो उस point of view से अगर तुम देखोगे कि certainly makes sense कि तुम उसका use जो जैसा बताया चंका ने जीएस में भी कर सकते हो इकोनॉमिक्स में कर सकते हो कहीं भी कर सकते हो ऐसे ऐसे जहाँ समझ में आ रहा है वहां पर कर सकते हो
स्पेशली इस बार इंडिया ईयर बुक में जो अच्छा नीति आयोग का 3-year एक्शन एजेंडा में आई वुड वेरी गुड यूज ऑफ इट इन पेपर 2, 3 एंड एस सी
एंड यू कैन कोट ऑल्सो एट द सेम टाइम
यू कैन कोट
तो दैट एज वेल कि पढ़ा हुआ है बंदे ने मतलब इट्स नॉट के स्टैटिक है अपने से एफर्ट डाला है राइट
दैट इज व्हाट आई वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट यू हैव टू लिमिट योर रिसोर्सेज एंड यूटिलाइज इट टू द मैक्सिमम एक्सटेंट बिकॉज इफ यू कोट नीति आयोग इन पेपर 2 एंड देन पेपर 3 पे नोबडी इज गोइंग टू से दिस ये बंदा एक ही किताब पढ़ के आया है 2 कोई और करेक्ट करेगा 3 कोई और करेगा एसए में कोई और करेगा